Okay, you'll be pleased to know you don't need any equipment or props for this week. And we're going to start by stretching out your shoulders and your neck and trying to release a bit of tension from there. So if you come to a comfortable seat on your bum with your legs crossed, if it's not hugely comfortable to sit with your legs crossed here, you can sit on something. I did say no props, but if you want to, you can sit on a rolled up towel. Something to elevate your hips can sometimes help you to sit up straighter if it's not comfortable here. Okay, so sitting comfortably. Take your hands behind your head. So it looks like this, hands behind your head. And then press the back of your skull into your hands. Take some deep breaths here into your belly. And then on an in-breath, push your head back, open your elbows, lift your chest, so a mini back bend. You probably won't move very far. We're just trying to get that feeling of a back bend. Big breath in. And then on the exhale, squeeze your elbows towards each other, tuck your chin to your chest. Squeeze your elbows together. Feel stretching your between your shoulders. And then on an in-breath, reverse it again, so push your head back. Try and press your elbows far away from each other, lift your chest. It's a little bit like doing happy cat, angry cat. And then on an exhale, pull everything back in. Press your elbows together, chin to your chest. And then inhale to open out again. Push your head into your hands. Lift your chin towards the ceiling. And then exhale. Elbows squeeze together, chin to chest. And breathe in one more time. Open out. And breathe out. Squeeze your elbows. Feel a stretch between your shoulders. Good. Take your hands back down towards the floor. Take one hand, let's say your left hand, so you're copying me, you're mirroring me. Take your left hand to the floor. Make a tent shape with your fingertips. And then take your right ear to your right shoulder. So you're tilting your head away from this hand. Push your fingertips into the floor as you magnetize your ear down towards your shoulder. Breathe, don't hold your breath. Feels good here, stay here. You can take your right hand across and hold on to your left ear, just really, really gently. And just kind of pull, so pull the skin upwards and away. So the skin of your ear and your neck, just kind of gently pull it. Stay here, or you can take your left hand off the floor, hover it, and flex your hand. So that's the point, and that's the flex. So you're pushing your fingers towards the ceiling. And then imagine there's a wall underneath your left hand and you're pushing into it. That's a really, really strong sensation. So push your palm into an imaginary wall. Okay, let's come out of it. Cool. Okay, other side. So right fingertips, make a tent with them. Push them into the floor, sit up straight, and then it's left ear to your left shoulder, so magnetize it down. Keep your chin relatively tucked. Okay, and then we're going to take our left hand over and hold on to our right ear and just gently give it a pull. So you're pulling at the skin. So you're not pulling your head, you're just kind of lifting your skin up. Push your fingertips into the floor, hold it here if that feels most useful for you, or you can hover your right hand off the floor and then push into an imaginary wall. So push your palm away from you, pull your fingertips towards you. Might feel really different on one side, this side feels really awkward to me. Probably means it's useful, probably means I need to do it more. You're pushing into that wall, all your fingers towards you. And then let's go, let go, good. That was pleasant, wasn't it? Come onto your horse. And we will, we've definitely done this one before, most of you, so we're going to do, it's called thread the needle. So, where's the best place for you to see me? I'll go here. So, let's take your right hand, and you're going to thread it under your left. So it's going to come all the way under. Back of your hand is on the floor. Bend your left elbow, so much so that the side, the right hand side of your face and head comes towards the floor. And then look at your left arm. Adjust your left hand so that your elbow is stacked above your wrist, so you've got a right angle. Push your left palm into the floor, and then edge your right hand, the back of your right hand, away from you along the floor. Take all of the weight out of your nose. Let your head be really heavy on the floor. Stay here. Your hips are going to have adjusted themselves over towards the left. So try and compensate for that by pushing them back towards the right. So especially kind of trying to push your left hip back. Breathe. Take the tension out of your neck. Let your head be heavy, close your eyes. Keep pushing your hand into the floor. Really strong with your left palm into the floor. And keep edging your right hand away from you. So we're mixing tension and relaxation here, so we're getting nice and squeezed into our arms. So pushing your hands away from you, but then relaxing your neck, letting your head be heavy. And relaxing your face. Let's come up and swap sides. So now it's your left hand going underneath your right. So thread it through and then take the left side of your face down to the floor. Adjust your right hand so that your right elbow is above your right wrist. Push your palm into the floor and edge your left hand away from you. So your shoulders are stacked almost one on top of the other. Find a comfortable place for your head and then take all of the weight out of your neck. Close your eyes, relax your face. Keep gently pushing your hands away from you. Into the floor with your right and away from you with your left. And then your shoulders, your hips will have shifted towards the left. So give them a quick push back to the right. And then let's breathe here. Take the tension out of your face. Push your head into the floor almost. From the side. We look like this from the side. And then let's come out. Stay on your hands and knees. Take your left hand behind your head. Point your left elbow towards the mat. Towards the floor, and then look at it with your eyes, and you're going to point your elbow towards the ceiling, follow it with your eyes, point it up, and then send it back down towards the floor. Keep following it with your eyes, so elbow to the floor, elbow to the ceiling. Let's time this with a breath, so breathe out as your elbow points towards the floor, breathe in, elbow to the ceiling, breathe out. Elbows to the floor. Breathe in. Breathe out. Try and get a bit further up each time. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Good. Let's change sides. So right hand behind your head. Point your elbow to the floor. Breathe all the way out. Breathe in to lift your elbow to the ceiling. Breathe out, point your elbow back to the floor. And try and get a little bit deeper
higher even each time as you breathe in.
Elbow goes higher towards the ceiling, breathe out.
Back towards the floor, breathe in. Breathe out, really pushing yourself open at the top, so breathe in.
Space between the front of your shoulders, breathe out.
Breathe in.
Breathe out.
One more. Breathe in.
Breathe out.
Good. Hands back to the floor. And then we're going to go into do some calf stretches here. So you're on all fours already, we might as well. So take your right leg back behind you, straight. And then edge your toes a little bit closer towards you, and then push back. So you're pushing your heel away from you. You're almost taking the weight off your left knee because you're pushing so strongly into that back foot. So it's a little bit like you're almost doing a plank. So I could take this leg off the floor if I wanted to because I'm pushing out so strongly into that back leg. Really, really strong. So you should feel like your quads burning now. You're having to really, really actively straighten your leg, like you're trying to push the back of your knee higher and higher. Push your heel away. And let's change sides. So take your other leg back behind you. Take your toes a little bit closer. And then push back. So you're pushing your heel away from you. Really, really active through your leg. So I've got my left leg behind me now. So really, really active. So I'm straightening my leg as strongly as I possibly can. So my quad is really hurting now. It's really burning. I'm having to really, really tense. Pushing the back of my knee towards the ceiling. I'm really actively pushing my heel away from the knee, pushing my hands into the floor. So, reminiscent of a plank. Good. Okay, let's stop that madness now. Okay, and we'll come into downward dog. So, as always, push into, not just into the heel of your hand. So, we're not trying to get all of that pressure dumping down into our wrists. Try and share the load, especially into the thumb and forefinger. So take the weight slightly forwards into your fingers, tuck your toes underneath you, push your hips up and back, especially push into the whole of your palms and not just your wrists. Try and take the weight forwards into where your fingers begin. It doesn't matter if your legs are straight or not. What matters is that your arms are nice and straight. And your head is relaxed. Chin to your chest. Let the crown of your head hang towards the floor. And try and push your shoulders down your back. So, shoulders away from ears. And then let's pedal your feet. So straighten one knee, bend the other. Straighten one knee, bend the other. It's like you're pedaling. So push one heel to the floor. And lift one heel all the way up. Other heel to the floor, one all the way up. So you'll probably find you can get one leg straight at a time. You can get one leg straight and your heel down at any one time, but maybe not both of them. So deep bend in one knee, deep flexion in your toes, and then deep flexion in your ankle on the other side. So I've got my right leg straight here, I'm pushing my right heel to the floor. And in my left leg, I've got a deep bend in my knee and a deep bend in my toes, real flexion in my toes, and then swap sides. So pedaling your feet. Shoulders away from ears, don't forget that. And then come to a still position. Forwards into a plank, and all the way down onto the floor. Shake your wrists out. And then let's take your elbows underneath your shoulders. So look down, elbows underneath shoulders, and then your forearms are parallel to each other. So fingertips pointing forwards. Push your palms into the floor, push your shoulders down and back. Mini back bend here. So you're trying to lift your chest. And as you dig your elbows into the floor, almost try and pull your elbows back towards your hips. They're not going to move, they're stuck to the floor. But if you push your elbows and palms into the floor and then pull them back towards your hips, you'll feel a nice stretch in your back. Good, and then let's stop that. Take your arms out in front of you and your face towards the floor. So I want you to lift your right leg. So push your right hip into the floor, lift your right leg, and then lift your left arm. So your face is pointing towards the floor, and we've got opposite arm and leg lifted, kind of like swimming, which is kind of what we're going to do now. So swap sides, so you're going to lift your left leg and right arm. Sorry, Chris. It's not just you that doesn't like right and left. Swap sides, that's where I say swap sides, because I can't remember left and right. So opposite arm and leg are lifting up, and then we're swapping sides, kind of like swimming. Keep exchanging between the two sides. Again, nice big squeeze up, and then swap sides. So move at your own pace, swap sides when you feel it's time. Opposite arm and leg lifting, and then swapping. And then let's stop. Push back onto all fours. Should we stretch our hips? Everyone likes to do that. Okay, after saying you don't need any props, you might again need a towel for this one. It's just something under your knees, because this can be quite hard on your knees. So if you're on a hard floor, even if you have a mat, it still might be quite hard on your knees. So you're going to take your knees from an all fours position, really wide. So knees as wide as they'll go, which might not be that wide, but take them as wide as they'll go. And then look back, point your toes out towards opposite sides of the room. So your toes are pointing out and your heels are in line with your knees. So your shins are pointing straight back behind you. So from this angle, more unattractive angle, this angle it looks like this. Okay? I'll come back to where you can see me from the front. And then take your hands forward slightly, and then you won't need to move very far to do this. You're going to push your hips very gently backwards. You won't get very far before you feel, oh, that's what we're meant to be feeling. So just for reference, if you want to have a look at how far back I'm going to go, it won't be very far. So I'm here, and I'm going to push my hips back to there. And breathe. If you want to find something to put under your knees, if you've realised why I said that now, feel free to stop. Pause the video, find something to put under your knees. If not, just find some sort of happy place to go to. We're going to push. So you can't, I'm not going to ask you to relax in this position because it's frankly not possible. What I am going to ask you to do instead is find a little bit of tension in this position. So really actively push your feet. The inner edges of your feet are going to be on the floor. Try and push them into the floor, almost like you're trying to take some of the weight out of your knees into your feet. So that should immediately relieve some of the pressure of your knees on the floor. So really, really push, push, push the inside edge of your feet to the floor. Take some weight into the inside of your feet. And you might find that you can get a little bit more movement access into your hips that way. Come forwards if you really need to release everything, and then come straight back into it. So support yourself on the inside edges of your feet. Tuck your tailbone under. Push back. If I'm going to tell you to relax anything, it will be your face, because your face probably isn't massively happy about what we're doing right now. So just try and pretend. I'm not going to ask you to relax into this pose. Instead, I want you to hold yourself in it. I want you to learn it. I want you to teach your body that this is a safe position to be in. Okay, enough of that. Let's stop. Okay, well done.
down the dog.
I should hit something back.
Yes. So let's find stillness in this downward dog. Just push your hips up. Push your heels towards the floor. They don't need to reach the floor. Push your heels towards the floor and your fingers towards the floor. And get your hips as high as you can. Almost like you're trying to point, if you've got a tail, the opposite of tucking your tail between your legs. So really try to lift your tailbone high. Like you're trying to make a happy cat position with your lower back. Lift your tailbone as high as you can get it. Happy cat position. Good. Look forwards. Come into a plank. And then let's take your right knee up to your chest. Let's bring your right knee in. And then aim your right foot to your right thumb. So we're in a lunge. Stand up in your lunge, find some balance. Take your arms alongside your ears, push your legs into the floor, lean back, and take it down, hands to the floor, step back to plank, and then swap sides. Bring your left knee into your chest, take your left foot to the inside of your left thumb, strong legs, stand up, lean back. Strong straight legs, deep bend in your left knee, and back down. Okay, we're going to swap sides again. So bring your right foot all the way through inside your right hand. Stand up, lean back, make like a crescent moon pose, shape, hands to the floor. Step back with your right leg, step forward with your left, make a lunge. Stand up, make a crescent moon shape with your back, hands back down, plank, let's do it again, right leg forwards, stand up, lean back, hands to the floor, step back with your right, step forwards with your left, strong through the legs, stand up. Lean back. Strong straight back leg. Bring it back down. Into a plank. Push back to down the dog very quickly. Deep breath in and out. Into a plank again. Bring your right leg forwards. So we're in the same position again. But this time I want you to edge your right foot slightly towards the right and take your right hand inside of your right leg. So from the side, it looks like this. So you edge this knee out a little bit. You're still in your lunge, but both arms are inside your right knee. Back leg is still straight. Push the floor away. Take your back knee to the floor. And tuck your back toes. Okay, so just hold it here. Let your hips be quite heavy. Push your hands into the floor. Deep breaths. Tuck your tailbone underneath you. Dig your right heel into the floor and try and engage your right leg. So try and dig your right heel into the floor and then almost, it's not going to move because you're not going to pull it that much, but I want you to push it into the floor and almost try and pull it back behind you. Like you're trying to bend your knee even further and that'll help you get deeper into the pose. So like you're trying to kick your bum with your heel. Rise a bit, so transfer the weight into your hands, tuck your back toes
toes underneath your leg, lift your knee, step back to plank, into downward dog, point your tailbone up, lift it up, lift it up, back to plank, and bring your left foot through to the inside of your left hand. Stay in your high lunge position so you've got your back leg straight, and then edge your left foot slightly away from you, so toe heel it away from you, and put your left palm to the inside of your left foot, so both hands are on the floor, and your left shoulder is inside your left knee. So hold it here, strong through your legs, keep straightening your back leg. Keep breathing. And then take your back knee to the floor. And tuck your back toes. Try and make all of your toes touch the floor. Okay, so get heavy here. Let your hips sink. Breathe. And take your attention to your left leg. So really push your left heel into the floor. And then make to dragging it back along the mat. So like you're trying to bend your left leg even further, like you're trying to kick your bum with your left heel. Drag it back, because it's not going to move, it's stuck to the mat. So at the same time as you're trying to move it, you're resisting the movement. And that will really help to deepen the twist. Not twist, deepen the stretch in the front of your right hip flexor, so you should feel it here. Good, tuck your back toes under. We'll revisit that in a moment. Tuck your back toes under, straighten your leg, step back to plank. Quick downward dog, lift your tailbone high. Come high on your toes this time. So lift your heels really, really high. Like you're standing up on tiptoes to reach something off the top shelf if you're vertically challenged like myself. Get really, really tall, strong, stretching your toes, and then put your heels back towards the floor, and then look forwards, come back to a plank, bring your right foot between your hands again. And then edge it out to the side. So we're revisiting this stretch that we've just done. So take your back knee to the floor. And this time we're going to twist it. So let's come up here. So we did this last week, you should remember this one. And we're going to twist. So you're going to take your left elbow outside your right knee. Wedge yourself into the position. Try not to come out of the pose here. So try not to make it a twist where you're straightening this leg. So you still want a really deep lunge here, okay? Make a prayer with your hands or make a platform and a fist, whatever you fancy doing. And twist. Push your left elbow into your right knee, the outside edge of your right knee, rather than the top of it, so get it around the outside. Push it into your knee and then resist it with your knee. It's a really strong twist. Breathe. Hold onto the floor with your feet, with your legs. And then let's swap sides, so come out of the twist, work your way back to a plank, and swap legs. So bringing your right knee to the floor, right toes to the floor, take yourself up onto your left knee, keep this depth in your hips. So don't lift up to come into the twist, or if you do lift up to come into the twist, make sure you sink back in to a deep hip stretch, pushing it towards the floor. So wedge your right elbow to the outside of your left knee. Make palm in a fist, or make a prayer position with your hands. Push them into each other. And then feel the twist come from your lower back. Look up over your top shoulder. Push your hips towards the floor. Hold onto the floor with your feet. So push the top of your back foot into the floor. And push your front heel into the floor. Hold onto the floor. And twist from your pelvis. From your lower back. Keep breathing. Step back to plank. One more downward dog. Lift yourself in. Deep breath. Really deep breath in. And out. Shoulders down and back, away from your ears. And then come to kneeling. Another twist to start kneeling, and then take your hips over to the left. So sit on your left hip. So you look a bit like this. Okay, so knees pointing forwards, and then look at your feet. You want your right foot to be pointing straight back. So right foot's pointing straight back, and you're kind of sitting on your left foot at the moment. Try and get the top of your left foot to sit on your right foot. So your right foot is pointing straight back, so you can see the whole of the sole of your right foot. And then you're kind of going to hook the top of your toes, top of your left toes, into the sole of your foot. It really doesn't massively matter if you don't get this. It's just a comfortable position to have your feet in. So then you zoom, pause the video and zoom in. So the foot that I'm sitting on is sitting on the foot that's on the floor. Back so you can see the front of me. Okay, so we're sitting on our right hip and we've got a comfortable position for our feet behind us. And then you're going to twist. So hold on to your left knee with your right hand and then lean back. So you're holding on to this knee as if it's trying to stop you from falling back. So this knee is going to push down as you hold on to it. So you've got equal and opposite forces. So you're pulling against the knee as it's pushing down. And then you're leaning back. So take your left hand to the front of your left shoulder. And imagine that this hand belongs to someone else and it's pushing your shoulder back. So it's helping you into the back bend. So turn your chest towards the left. Slightly look over your left shoulder. Got your left hand helping to pull you back. So we're in a back bend here. Back bend and a twist. And then you can take your left hand to the floor, so fingertips to the floor like that tent shape we made earlier. Push your fingertips into the floor, get pressure in the floor, so press your fingertips into the floor. Straighten your left arm, so both arms are straight, both arms are working, both arms are creating a bit of tension to work against, and that's helping you stretch, that's helping your chest open. Then your back twist. Look over your left shoulder. Push strongly into the floor with your left fingertips and pull into your left knee with your right hand, but then resist it with your knee. Good. Let's change sides. So switch over the hip that you're on, so you're going to go your right hip now. And then you want your left foot on the floor, left foot and ankle on the floor, and your right toes, top of your right toes, top of your right foot is sitting on the inside of your left foot, the sole of your left foot. So they're just neatly stacked one on top of the other, with your left foot on the floor and your right foot on top of it. Okay. And then we're twisting again. So take your left hand, hold onto your right knee. So try and wedge it slightly under your knee. So you can push down with your knee and pull against it with your hand.
So do that now. So push with your knee, pull with your hands. Get a back bend. Okay, so push your chest forwards. Right hand, right shoulder, as if it belongs to someone else, and it's going to pull your shoulder back. Look over that shoulder. Deep breath in and out. And then take your right fingertips to the floor. Make a tent shape with your fingertips and push them into the floor. Straighten your arm. Resistance against the floor with your fingertips. Push into the floor. Look over your shoulder. So you're twisting, pushing, and pulling. Twisting with your spine, pushing with your right fingertips, pulling with your left hand. Get a little bit deeper. Keep breathing. Good. Come back to the middle. And let's come to kneeling. You can either have your knees together, feet together, your knees wide and your feet together. Totally up to you. Push your hips back on your heels. Take your head to the floor. Take your arms behind you, top of your hands to the floor, crown of your head to the floor. Let your shoulders be heavy towards the floor. The top of your shoulders weighing down towards the floor. Forearms on the floor, palms facing the ceiling. Hips on your feet, take all of the weight out of your neck. Forehead on the floor, let it be really heavy, so let your forehead press into the floor. If your forehead doesn't reach the floor, you can make two fists with your hands and put them one on top of each other. Two hands, two fists, and put your forehead on your fist. And take the weight out of your neck that way, so really let your head be heavy on your fists. Or if your head reaches the floor, it can stay on the floor. And then stay here for as long as you fancy, basically. And that's you done. Well done. Hope you enjoyed that.